Hello viewers, thank you for allowing me in your presence and in your homes. My name is Apostle Helen Rudokeno, coming to you on the waves of Majesty Christian Television Network. Shall we pray? Father, I thank you once again and I bless you. Let this moment be useful to me and to all our hearers. I pray that you will bless them and bless them real good as they spend time to hear your word. Heal somebody that is sick. Lord, I pray for those who have some needs that you will minister to their needs and you will help somebody who have unbelief to become truly a child of God. I want to thank you that there is grace available to make them whatever they wish to become, which is acceptable in your presence. Be glorified and be exalted, Lord, in Jesus' name. Joyfully say a big amen. I want to appreciate those of you who make time to go to church every Sunday. God richly, richly bless you. And if you are listening to this broadcast and you do not have any church, you are churchless. I welcome you joyfully to Rivers of Life Bible Church, where people are being transformed by the power of the word. So please, join us every Sunday from 11 o'clock. And I believe that you will never regret it. So if in case you would want, please look on the screen and then you will see a contact address and at the same time a contact number. Just call us and then tell us where you are and then we can see how to arrange to pick you up. God richly, richly bless you. Now, in our special assignment this evening to either continue with the topic which I've been handling for the month, because I was thinking about changing it, but all of a sudden the Holy Ghost told me, no, this is the topic for the month. So this topic, you just have to preach on it and bless my people. So the topic has to do with the wind of change. Say wind of change. Hallelujah. Wind of change. Why is it necessary? It's very important that you change. I mean, that the wind blows around you and then give you a different perspective. Because sometimes when you stay in one particular environment or circumstance and you are viewing things, you don't really see it accurate. So time comes when you're supposed to change or something happens around, you know, to blow you probably out of that very environment or to unveil things that are covered so that you can see and see accurately. Are you hearing me, somebody? There are people who have been very stagnant. It is about time that you experience a wind of change that will move you to your desired location. Can I hear a very big amen? Yeah, there are people who are single. They want to settle down. And every year, they've been asking God for that very petition. I am here to let you know that something different is going to happen to you and for you. And I will rejoice together with you. Because it's going to be something very beautiful. Say, I hear you. And others as well. Probably you are asking God for employment. And you are looking for a job. This is your very month. There are others who are crying out for healing. This is also your month. Because God is going to lift you out from that place of affliction and release you from the hand of the devil that have been tormenting you, and then you are going to really experience a healthy lifestyle. Say a big amen. So it can be that you want to further your education. I don't know what it is, or you are desiring just to have something. Let the wind of change blow around you. It is my desire that God will blow some wind around you and empower you, enable you, energize you, and make you become who you must be. Say, I hear you. Now, I told us clearly, just like the wind blows and we don't know where it is coming or where it is going, it's anybody that is being led by the Spirit. And I told us that we are supposed to be led by the Spirit when we are in God's kingdom. That means we do no more do things the way we're supposed to do. We do things the way God expects them to be done. So when we have been programmed by people to know when they to monitor us and to know when we start and when we end, that is not really being led by the Spirit. So any person that is expecting a wind in this season or wind of change around him or her must be ready to do exactly what God wants you to do. That means you are no more being bound by religion or being bound by tradition. tradition, being bound by a culture, you must just be like wind. Just like the wind blows and we do not know where it's coming and where it's going, it's anybody who is led by the Spirit. People have predicted who you must be. People have predicted what must come out of you. But it's time now that God himself steps in and begins to tell them or let them know that, no, what you think this person is, it's not really what a person is. Let that wind of change blow, whereby they will no more be able to figure you out and determine what comes out of you. Let the wind of change blow to move you from your stagnant situation to your place of acceptance. Are you hearing me? To where you will become movable, to where you will begin to interpret the dreams of those who think that you cannot really be anything, to where you begin to be a support, a backbone to those who think that your situation has finished. Say, I hear you, woman of God. If you are the one I'm speaking to, say, I hear you again, woman of God. Hallelujah. I feel excited because I know what I'm preaching is real. And it is coming from the throne of heaven to strengthen you, to help you and jack you up to become who God wants you to be. You've been far too long alone. And it's time that the Holy Ghost wants to relocate you. He wants to pour out immeasurable grace around you so that you will be able to become who he wants you to be. That's why the wind is very necessary. I told us that wind signifies some certain things in the Bible. Biblically, it signifies the Holy Spirit. It signifies our affliction. It signifies the presence of God. It signifies the power of God. It signifies temptation coming your way. It signifies divine presence. Wind signifies it signifies revival. Say revival. So I've dealt with the rest of the ones I made mention about. Like I said, it signifies God's divine presence, and that you will find in 1 Kings chapter 19 from 11 to 12. It signifies temptation, that you will find in the book of Matthew chapter 8 from verse 24 to 26. It signifies affliction, just like Job had affliction which crept all the children within one day. So you find that in Job 1 from 18 to 19. Wind signifies power or strength of God. Are you hearing me? Just like he breathed upon the nostrils of a man of that which he formed, and that little mud became a living soul. So you find it in Genesis chapter 2 from verse 7. And wind signifies the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. You find it in John chapter 20, verse 22, where Jesus breathed upon the disciples and he told them, receive ye the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. So I want us to examine wind as a symbol of revival. That we will find in the book of Ezekiel. Please quickly take your Bible and let's go to Ezekiel chapter 37. Ezekiel chapter 37, and I read from verse 9 to 10. The Bible says, then said he unto me, that's God took Ezekiel to the valley of dry bone, and this is God telling Ezekiel. So he said unto me, prophesy unto the wind, prophesy, son of man, and say to the wind, thus says the Lord God, come from the four winds, O breath, and breath upon this slain, that they may live. So I prophesied as he commanded me, and the breath came unto them, and they lived and stood up from their feet, an exceeding great army. If you are conversant with this Bible scripture in Ezekiel 37, the Bible told us that Ezekiel was taken down to the valley, and while Ezekiel was taken down to the valley by vision, by dream, Ezekiel was expecting God to show him what was how God was going to deliver the people of Israel from captivity, how he was going to, take them to wherever that they could, have a pleasant life, because Israel had been bombarded at this time by different Amalekites and the rest of their enemies who have been attacking them all the time. So Israel is like lost favor before God, and then lots of things were happening. So here was Ezekiel on his knees, believing that God would do something for them, believing that God could, remember that they were descendants of Abraham, that these were the people God had promised that they would be in Canaan land. And here they were in their captive land, and the people were inviting them, taking their wives, sleeping with their daughters, and killing their men. So a lot of things were happening. So Ezekiel was looking for solution. But guess what? The Bible told us that God allowed Ezekiel to sleep. So when he was put to sleep, Ezekiel now was had a dream, or was taken through a vision into a dry a valley that was filled with dry bones. And then God asked Ezekiel, go around this dry this valley and check and see whether they were really living or dead. So Ezekiel was so surprised. Ezekiel went round and round and then looked, and the bones were really dry. These were bones of people that have died generation to generation, and they were all in the valley. Are you hearing me? So this wasn't just an ordinary valley. It was a grave. So the vision he had was a vision of a graveyard. So he was taken to a graveyard when he was expecting to see high buildings, when he was expecting to see the bright future of Israel, when he was expecting to see, you know, your great businesses being flourished around the people of Israel. But God showed him a contrary thing. How do you feel when God would open up your eye to see something contrary? You want to see yourself married. You want to see yourself having your own children. You want to see yourself, you know, living to your maximum. You want to see yourself being who exactly God wants you to be, you know, doing things just the way other people are doing things. But here, God is just only showing you, allowing you to see dreams of frustration, you falling from heights, you being you know, battered and being put in a stagnant position. That was the situation that Ezekiel had. So Ezekiel was really devastated when his dream was of that of a graveyard. And then God told Ezekiel, prophesy over this situation, and prophesy and speak exactly the word I'm commanding you to speak. Tell the wind to come, and the wind will come. Tell those things that have no life, let breath enter you, breath enter them. And then he prophesied again. He said, he commanded the breath to come from the four corners of the earth, and let breath fill these people. And they all became alive, and they stood exceedingly great army in front of him. So you can imagine, you can see how he must have been amazed that he saw them dry. He was looking at them dry. He was looking at empty skeletons, and they had no form. They had nothing. These were bones that have been there for 200 years, 300 years. And here, God was telling him to prophesy. And he prophesied. When he prophesied, something happened. He prophesied, and wind had to come. Wind had to be blown. And then all of a sudden, revival began to take place, even in the valley. Are you hearing me, somebody? All of a sudden, something he never expected began to take place in the valley. Child of God that is listening to this broadcast, I want you to know that no matter the situation you are in, that there could still be a revival happening around you. Revival is possible when God is very, very active in your life. Are you hearing me? So I said to us that wind is a symbol of revival. Some of you are going to have revival in this season. Some of you are going to experience revival. It's going to be an unusual wind that is going to blow around you. Sometimes when that wind begins to blow, it's going to be as if it's going to blow you off. But listen to me, when God is in control and God is in situation of he is at the center of your life, he will not allow you to go beyond the level he wants you to go. He will not allow any temptation that is higher than you to come you, or anything that is bigger than you to come your way. God will make sure he gives you enough grace to be able to overcome whatever that is hitting around you. Say, I hear you. So Ezekiel, the Bible said, began to prophesy. He began to prophesy. He began to prophesy. Oh, wind, come over these people who are dry. Come over these dried people. Come over these dry bones. The Bible told me bones began to shake, bone to bone. These are people who have been lying there all of these years. You know, they have been buried, and they have been jammed and mixed up together. But how was it that bone of Samuel was able to know that this is the bone of Samuel, the bone of John, the bone of Deborah, the bone of Jakita, and all of that? They all began to form bone to bone, and they were able to fit in properly properly into the right place, into the right position. Are you hearing me? The bone of the ear, even the tiny ear, this tiny ear had bones that controls it. Do you know that the bone of the ear didn't go to the nose or go to the side of the eye? It went exactly to the right spot. The bone for Helen was able to find Helen and was able to fix at the right and proper place. There are things that are happening around you. People are written you off. And you seem too dry. And it is as if that life is no more in you. I am preaching this message for you. It is for you because you are going to experience a change. Within a twinkle of an eye, Jehovah God, the one I stand before his presence, is going to transform you. Say, I hear you. I say, he will do it for you. He will make it for you. Where your visions have been aborted. Because these people were in the dry valley. They were in the grave. You know, because the Bible was so polite just to call it valley of dry bones. That wasn't just a valley. I present to you, child of God, that was a cemetery. That was where this man went. Are you hearing me? The man of God was taken to the cemetery, not just to a valley. It was a cemetery filled with only dry bones. In the graveyard, you don't see any living soul. You only see people who are rotten. You only see people who are dead. You only see things that are lifeless. So that could be your situation. That could be what is happening around you. Your circumstances have made you so lifeless. You can't perform. You can't function. You smell when you pass around. People don't want to reckon with you because they think that when they reckon with you, you only have problems. You only have, you know, issues to present. Actually, people don't like those who present them with only troubles. They like people who celebrate them. They like where you are ready-made, and they come and they begin to be acquainted with you. Now you are like those in the dry bone, those in the valley. Nobody wants to reckon with you. Nobody wants to identify with your ministry. Nobody wants to identify with your marriage. Nobody wants to identify with your children because they are in drugs, because they are whore, because your husband is a drunkard. He is a gambler. Nobody wants to identify with you. That could be your situation. Child of God, listening to me, you may be that person in that dry valley where it is that every beauty around you is gone. Oh, people have married and married, but except you. People around you, they have all married. Your senior ones, your younger ones have married. Those that you senior, they have married, but it's like nobody is coming to knock at the door, even to ask you, how are you? Even to date you, talk less of marrying you. Your situation may be like that, but hear ye the word of the Lord. God is coming for you. He is coming to fetch you. I'm positioned to jack you up in this hour to let you know that the wind of change will blow around you and you will be blown into your revival. Say, I hear you. Say, revival, come. Hey, come and say it. Say, revival, come by me. Say, revival, come. You see, they were in the valley. They were not expecting revival to come. They were not expecting that they would come back to life. But the wind of change blew. Because a man of God spoke forth a word. I may not be a man. I am proud to be a woman. But you know one thing? I'm speaking the word of God. And if I be a servant of Jehovah, what I'm speaking will come to pass into your life. Let the wind of change blow. It's enough. It's enough. Enough is enough that you remain in poverty. You remain in constant poverty, in constant drainage, as if God doesn't answer prayer. I am presenting to you a God that transforms people. I'm presenting to you a God that answers prayer. I'm presenting to our generation a God that can make impossible become possible. Say, I hear you. Hallelujah. Wind of change. Let it blow around you. Ha! When that wind begins to blow, people who dumped you, they have written you off. They say, hey, you are never do well person. They've written you off. They will come back looking for you. I said, they will come back. I see them coming back. I see them coming back. They will come back and they will stand in front of you because God has remembered you. You will have answer to what they need. Israel needed army. Israel needed soldiers. Israel needed people that will go and confront their enemies. Behold, these people were in the valley. They were empty. They were lifeless. But when the wind of change blew around them, hey, they were jacked up. The wind of change will blow around you. And then you will now realize that you are the answer for your generation. I'm going to end up here today because of time. But I believe that you have been blessed. I believe that God will do something new. I prophesy over you as a servant of Jehovah, let wind of change blow around you and blow you into your place of celebrity. You've been rejected for too long in that valley as a poor man, as a poor woman, as a poor child of God. Who told you that the gospel is only for the poor? Who told you that? We serve a rich God. We serve a rich God. We serve a God who even heaven is made of streets. Or the streets of heaven, they are made with gold. If God will say he doesn't have money, perchance, let me just use that word. But God will always have any currency you need. But he can also remove just one layer of the street of heaven. And it's enough to pay all your rent and give you the money that you need for life. Are you hearing me, somebody? Think about it. The God who says silver is mine, gold is mine, the human beings, they are also mine. Every single thing that we need and every single thing that we think we want to have is in God's hand. So if you serve him diligently, you will be able to receive the wind of change that will move you from nobody to somebody. It is my desire that where you have been worshiping God like a carnal believer, where you have been full of doubt and you don't want to believe that God is able, that the wind of change will blow in your mind and you will stop seeing God from your logical thought. It's not about, I was telling people in the church today, I said it's not about your degrees. God is not interested in your degrees, in your be somebody. He's not interested. Because when you come before God, put yourself down. That's the only way the wind can blow around you. Put yourself, make yourself humble. Be obedient to the word of the living God. And then you will see the manifestation of the word in your present life. He's not a God of after. He's a God of now. When you serve him good, you will see the wind of change blowing around you. The reason why many, I'm so sick and tired of so many people coming into the house of God, they come in and they go empty. They come to church, they go empty. They come in, they go empty. They come into crusade grounds, they go empty. There are some of you looking at me. I've laid hands and laid hands and laid hands and laid hands. 20 years ago, I laid hands on you. You are still on the same spot. What's wrong? Is it that God doesn't fulfill his word? Or is it that you are the cause of your situation? But even if that is the situation, I pray in Jesus' name that the wind of change will blow and that you will no more be a carnal believer. You know, a carnal believer, I was telling them today in the church, I said, there are people who they do not, God is not seated at the throne of their heart. They put God aside. So at the throne of their heart is themselves. Me. And then they put God aside. So below the throne is not God, but the below the throne is their business, their marriage, their children, their school, their this, their that. So God is outside their curriculum. Is that your situation? Because if that be your situation, the wind of change, when it blows, it will rather blow you into a place of disaster. It will not blow and bring good news to you. It will blow and then it will blow you into more disaster. Child of God, better to humble yourself and allow God to sit at the throne of your heart. And then you can participate in the blessing that is meant for his children. The year is still young. We are in the fourth month. But I'm praying that you will catch up the vision. And then you will run with the vision. And you will be able, you know, to know what is good and acceptable will of God for you. It is enough that you start your year and end it same, old. It is time that the wind of change blows around you so that you will experience your blessings. And God will be well pleased that you have gone a little bit further than what you have been doing all the year. I thank God for your life, and please, partnership with me, you know, text me some of your needs, let me pray alongside with you. You can Google me on Facebook, connect with me on Twitter, connect with me on all of the social media, just my name, Apostle Helen Rudokeno, And then tell me how I can be a blessing to you. And I believe that I will surely partnership with you, and your life will not be the same anymore. I want to rejoice over your testimonies. Just like you are rejoicing over me, I want to rejoice over you too. God richly bless you, and I hope to see you again by this time next week. Bye.